Hello and welcome to the big picture. Delhi has witnessed for the last 2 days an unusual gathering of people from across the country at Jantar Mantar. The media, of course, has not taken as much interest about this gathering as it did when Anna Hazare or Baba Ramdev had their gatherings. But this gathering is no less important as they consist of the elderly people who are demanding an universal pension. The 5-day pension parishad has seen a gathering of over 3,000 people from 22 states belonging to marginalized communities, elderly, deprived, disabled, and displaced from their own homes by their children. How we as a country treat our elderly decides how civilized we are. Just a couple of statistics to drive home the point where we stand. There are over 88 million people in this country who are above the age of 60 years, out of which 75% live in rural areas. 48% of them are women and 55% of them are widows. 3 out of 5 single older women are very poor, and 2 out of 3 elderly people in rural areas are fully dependent. It is in this context that the demand for a universal pension is being raised. Today we are discussing this demand and asking the question, has the time come now for a universal pension in this country? To discuss this, I have with me Nikhil, the well-known activist, Poornima, Chikermane, a social activist who works with the unorganized sector, Vimala, a grassroot activist from Silampur in Delhi, who has spent 30 years fighting for the deprived and marginalized people in her area and brings here all those years of experience of suffering and witnessing the suffering of the elderly, and also Dr.Bhalchandra, Mungekar, a Congress MP in the Rajya Sabha, and someone who understands these problems from personal experiences very well. Welcome to all my guests. Let me go to Dr. Mungekar first. Dr. Mungekar, you have been in the Planning Commission. You understand these issues. You, in fact, I think even drafted a bill on this issue. Where does the government stand now as far as this demand is concerned?
See, basically, the question is, even 2008, this bill was drafted on 2007. There was sufficient discussion in the Planning Commission, and personally, between the minister, because I was privileged to be the in charge of labor in the Planning Commission, I wanted somewhat stronger bill than this.
Yes.
What happened today is that today, under Indira Gandhi Old Age Pension Scheme, those are above 65, they are getting 200 rupees per month.
Right.
And those are above 80, they are getting 500 rupees per month.
Right.
Now, this is absolutely peanuts so far as inflation is concerned, and so far lack of any security is concerned. Now, my point is, as you rightly mentioned and began this debate, I think the time has come now, after the last 20 years of economic reforms, which certainly has brought relatively high rate of growth, but this country's policy and we as a nation, we miserably failed in reaching the benefits of economic growth to the relatively marginalized sections of the society, of which these people, those who are now marching near Jantar Mantar and yesterday addressed them,
yes,
they are overwhelmingly the largest part of that. That's why, as you rightly mentioned, time has come to universal pension, and the demand of for those people, those who are demanding pension, and I am part of that, 2,000 rupees or the minimum wage, which is lower, that is their demand for a pension per month, and universalization. And I think throughout the world now, when the social security schemes are declining, France, you see the result. France result and the Labour Party has come to the power,
right,
simply because the erosion of the social security scheme. According to me, that is repeated in Greece. Whole Europe will be going through this turmoil. I suggest that the government of India must awaken to this and try to ensure. We can debate about whether it is 1,000, 2,000 or 1,500. But
yeah,
I think taking into account the highly inegalitarian society and unequal benefits of economic growth, we have now come to the stage where we should go for universal pension scheme.
Okay. Okay, Dr. Mungekar, please stay on. I'll come back to you. Nikhil, he was mentioning about the Indira Gandhi pension scheme, which the central government's contribution is 200 rupees. And the state governments are expected to contribute to it. And roughly, if I go by the papers which I have seen, it comes to about roughly about 500 to 1,000 rupees, which the people get across the country, depending on different states?
Many states you get only 200.
200.
Yeah.
So now you're asking the demand is for 2,000 rupees.
Yeah, the first demand actually is universalizing it.
Right.
First demand is to make sure that people
Let me get this right.
Yeah.
When you say universalizing it, it means it is not just for people below the poverty line.
That's right.
It is for every individual who crosses the age of 60, 65, whatever it is.
Absolutely, Girish. Except we are saying that you can have certain exclusions, those who are taxpayers, those who get an organized sector pension. Those can be excluded, but it is universalization without this pernicious BPL list and line, which we have been battling with over and over again for years. And we have come to a point where even government agrees we should get rid of it. And for these people who have been working all their lives, contributing to the nation's development, to this growth rate that we've all enjoyed, and when they reach an age where their bodies don't help them and they right. cannot contribute anymore, and they can't fall back on that to earn, they have nothing to fall back on. So actually, this is not a dole, and then they become BPL. They are poor. They cannot earn. They cannot live.
Absolutely.
So I completely agree with Dr. Mungekar, and I think that there is no question that we have to. The time has come to address the concerns of a huge segment of our society. There are 10 crore people who are actually above the age of 60 around this time, and many, many of them in an acute status of distress. And if we do not address that distress, we do not deserve to call ourselves a nation with economic development or economic strength of any kind.
Right. Poornima, coming to you. You have been working among the unorganized sector.
Now, yes.
Taking what both Dr. Mungekar and Nikhil has spoken about, you know, the fact of the matter is, it is not just the unorganized sector. People above the age of 65, 60, 65, 70, even if their children are well off and things like that, we have seen cases where people really don't have cash on hand to make, you know, they feel. So this universalization is not just going to help the disorganized sector, but it's also going to help people who are in dire circumstances, neglected by their children, despite the fact that children are very well off or reasonably well off.
Yeah, I mean, like Nikhil said, what we're looking at is exclusions of income tax payees, those who are working in the formal sector and have some kind of pensions, have something to fall back upon.
Right.
Now, if the parents of well-to-do children are really not taking of the parent care of the parents, and the parents are in a very vulnerable state where they have no other recourse but to, you know, kind of be dependent on somebody, then yes, certainly the state will cover them.
Should cover them. Yes. Okay, let me come to Vimalaji. Vimalaji, aap Silampur se aate hain. Silampur mein bahut saal se aap kaam kar rahe hain. आप अपना कुछ पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस बताइए ना कि ये इस तरह के जो मूवमेंट जो एक मूवमेंट की तरह निकल रहा है इस पे आने का आपका मोटिवेशन क्या था?
मैं पिछले 30 साल से सिर्फ सीलमपुर नहीं दिल्ली की बहुत सारी बस्तियों में काम करती हूँ और अपने अनुभवों से जो मैंने देखा है कि लोगों को पेंशन क्यों ज़रूरी है क्योंकि सरकार कहती है कि जिसका 18 साल से बड़ा बच्चा है उसको नहीं मिलेगी जिसके घर में दो बच्चे लड़के कमाने वाले हैं उनको नहीं मिलेगी आपको पूरे कागज़ चाहिए डॉक्यूमेंट्स पूरे चाहिए अब इन हालातों में जो हम देखते हैं कि बीमार हैं खाने को नहीं है क्योंकि अभी बेरोजगारी बढ़ी है महंगाई बढ़ी है राशन कार्ड नहीं है पहचान पत्र नहीं है तो आपको पेंशन नहीं मिलेगी दलाल को आपको नहीं दे सकते तो आपको पेंशन नहीं मिलेगी
और बच्चे पेंशन की जब, कितना मिल दिल्ली में कितना
दिल्ली
मिलता है
मैं अभी पिछले दो साल पहले तो कम था अभी 1,000 रुपया हो गया है लेकिन दिल्ली का ये है
वो कि 1,000 रुपए मिलने में कितना कोशिश उठाना पड़ता है
वो 1,000 तो आपको पता ही है सरकार की जेब से पैसा निकालना आसान नहीं है संघर्ष तो खूब करना पड़ता है लेकिन संघर्ष के साथ साथ कुछ मिल जाता है तो थोड़ा उन लोगों को मदद मिल जाती है अभी उनको क्यों ज़रूरी है क्योंकि बीमार हैं बच्चे अगर उनके कमाने वाले हो भी गए हैं जो सरकार बोलती है तो पुश्तैनी जायदाद तो है नहीं उनके पास बैंक बैलेंस तो है नहीं वो तो रोज़ कमाना रोज़ खाना तो बच्चों की अगर शादी हो गई वो तो अपना परिवार लेके बैठेगा या अपने माँ बापों की देखभाल करेगा
ये अगर बीमार पड़ गए तो उसको कोई देखने वाला नहीं
कोई देखने वाला नहीं तो बीमारी इस समय खाने से ज़्यादा बीमारी पर पैसा लग रहा है सरकारी हॉस्पिटलों में सुबेरे 5 बजे 4 बजे से लाइन लगा लेते हैं। अब नंबर आएगा, नंबर आने के बाद आपको डॉक्टर देखेगा, डॉक्टर देखने के बाद आपको दवाई की लाइन में लगने का, वो दवाई मिलेगी या नहीं मिलेगी कोई वो नहीं है। तो इसी कारण से लोग जाते भी नहीं हैं, बहुत मजबूर होते हैं तो वो सुबेरे से 2 रोटी बांधी और पूरे दिन के लिए चले गए। तो अभी जो खाने के साथ साथ जो बीमारी है वो हम देख रहे हैं कि पिछले कई सालों से बीमारी से बहुत लोगों की मृत्यु हुई है, खासकर टीबी जैसा बीमारी है, कुपोषण बच्चों में है। क्योंकि वो बोलते हैं कि आपके घर में 2 कमाने थे, उनका तो खुद का पेट नहीं भर रहा है, अपना ही बच्चा मर रहा है तो माँ बापों को क्या। कई जगह तो हमने ये देखा कि माँ बाप भीख मांगने चले जाते हैं।
बहुत सारे ऐसे बुजुर्ग लोग हम देखते हैं रास्ते में जो भीख मांग रहे हैं। डॉक्टर मुंगेकर, यू नो दैट व्हाट विमला इज टॉकिंग अबाउट, इट इज नॉट जस्ट द पेंशन, इट्स ऑल्सो द अदर मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग और वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज ऑल्सो द हेल्थ केयर।
No, that is what she is saying is absolutely right. If we see the per capita monthly expenditure during last 2 or 3 out of national sample survey,
right,
we find that progressively the bottom level people, bottom 40%, 40% people, they are spending relatively larger portion of their monthly income on health because during last 15-20 years, health and education, they are becoming fast privatized. And right, privatization means even general hospitals are collapsing across the country.
Absolutely.
In your Sabdarjung Hospital, Loknayak Jain Hospital, Ramnagar Lohia Hospital, 60-70,000 people every day they are going for OPD.
Right.
And the system is collapsing. That's why this, what she says, absolutely she is right. And second point according to me is, वो जो पेंशन का जो मामला है, वो पेंशन का मामला न सिर्फ वो लोगों के हित के लिए है, लेकिन अभी प्राइम जो फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर ने बात जो किया है, डिमांड ड्रिवन ग्रोथ, यदि ये निचले लोगों के हाथ में यदि थोड़ा पैसा जाएगा, चाहे 1,500 और 1,000 रुपीज़, तो उसका डोमेस्टिक मार्केट बढ़ाने के लिए साइज, डोमेस्टिक साइज मार्केट इंडिया इज़ वेरी ह्यूज। तो मैं समझता हूँ कि डोमेस्टिक साइज, डोमेस्टिक डिमांड, डोमेस्टिक रिकवरी और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग मैनेजर का ढांचा बनेगा, और इन लोगों को पैसा देने के बाद जो मार्केट बढ़ाएगा, जो रोजगार बढ़ाएगा, उसका इंक्लूसिव ग्रोथ जो गवर्नमेंट चाहते हैं,
so,
जो इलोन प्लान, so, वो इंक्लूसिव ग्रोथ के लिए भी
डॉक्टर मुंगेकर, डॉक्टर मुंगेकर अलोंग विद एनआरईजीए समथिंग लाइक दिस विल आल्सो केटर टू द डिमांड ड्रिवन ग्रोथ व्हिच द गवर्नमेंट एंड प्लानिंग कमीशन टॉक्स अबाउट।
दैट इज राइट।
ओके, वी नीड टू टेक अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक नाउ, विल कम बैक वेरी सून, प्लीज कीप वॉचिंग। Welcome back. We are discussing the demand for universal pension and seeing how necessary it is today. Coming to you, Nikhil, what are the roadblocks and the hurdles which are happening now? And you know, I'm sure there are people who will say that this is going to be a dole, and then again, the same kind of arguments which we see as when it comes to NREGA, we'll find the same kind of arguments here also. How do you, how are you going to, counter those arguments?
Yeah, I think the first thing is to understand that what exists today is pathetic and unacceptable. That is something I would really like to hear someone say that, no, it's great. It doesn't, it's not possible to say so. So it's unacceptable, so it has to change. So is the situation as far as those people are concerned. The biggest thing in Jantar Mantar is there are people who speak for themselves. There's nothing to say. You just look at them. You hear one line from them, all they need to say. Today the rural development minister came to Jantar Mantar, he heard for himself, and there were people speaking one line at a time, that's all they needed to say. And their stories are something that we all need to actually listen. It's all around us, but we need to listen to it.
Absolutely.
Collectively.
Yeah.
And across the board, MPs have been coming from across parties and saying, yes, we are mobbed by people when we go to the villages, who are desperate when we go even to our cities, who are desperate to get into some kind of income security. Now, that's something, it is not a dole. They also all understand that. These are people who have worked. They are not, they have never shirked work.
Yes.
But they can't work anymore. They are working at 65, 70 on NREGA sites. Today we had another MP who said that there are people, 30% people of old people, because they are forced to come there. They have no other place.
Nearly, so it is said that nearly 60% of these people are forced to work.
Absolutely. So under these conditions, now if you say we don't have the money, if you don't have the money, you don't have the money to feed people, you don't have the money for education, you don't have the money for health, you don't have the money. We are always accused of asking for more and more money. For what? We are asking for the most basic things. That's what governments are for. That's what countries are for. That's what societies are for. If we cannot meet the needs of people, ordinary people who have done the most basic, ordinary hard work through their lives, I don't know what kind of a society we are. It's our business to say we will overcome that. And it's not great amounts of money. We can throw money, 5 lakh crores and subsidies for the rich.
What is the expected expenditure if we have universal pension of 2,000 rupees for
across
people above 60 years?
Yeah, so it will work out to about 2% of our GDP.
Right.
Now, it's true that 2% of our GDP, if we look at it in terms of money, everyone says, oh, 2 lakh crores, it's a huge amount of money. But countries poorer than India, Nepal, South Africa, are providing universal pension schemes at more, much more than what we are providing. We do not provide actually for our social security. We do not provide for our basic necessities in this country. So we have to contend with that. Today, though, let us at least start moving in the right direction. Let us accept, which we've been accepting, that this BPL business must go, that universalization must come in, that 300 is a completely unacceptable amount, 200 or 300, that we must move up, maybe not to 2000 today, but let's, we say 2000 because it's completely logical. Any one of your viewers can think of what they would require to live, especially when they are old, when they need medicines, when they are elderly. But chalo, let's look at the budget also and see what is affordable. We cannot have these people saying, oh, yet another set of people coming to bleed the country.
Let me get, yeah, Dr. Mungekar on this. Yeah. Dr. Mungekar, 2% of the GDP. I mean, you must be, you have been in the planning commission. You are now, you continue to interact with the government very closely. Is this something, a huge amount, as far as the planning commission or the government is concerned, the finance ministry? You think there will be problems in the finance ministry or the planning commission for such a, for 2% of the GDP to be, you know, set aside for this kind of a social security scheme?
No, I think it is very, very important question. That's why I said that it could be negotiable 1,000, 1,500 or 2,000. See, basically, when your annual plan itself is roughly around 5,21,000 crores, say 2012 to 2013, and then 100% while appreciating and demanding and justifying and even struggling for universal pension scheme, I do not think, and all my colleagues, I must convince them, present financial position would not permit to go for 2,000 rupees per month. It will be approximately 2 lakh crores. That's why my point is, whatever other schemes are taken into account, if we can implement Jan Suraksha Yojana, if we go for Vima Yojana, if we go for rigorous implementation of Mahatma Gandhi Employment Guarantee Scheme, if we go for proper PDS, public distribution system, all these steps taken together, better implementation, will definitely allow the government to revise the pension demand from 2,000 to say even 1,000. In the present situation, even if government is ready, and I will try to convince the government that even if at this moment of time, if government is able to provide even 1,000 rupees pension per month,
right,
by making adjustment of all other welfare programs taken together, I think that will be a great achievement.
Okay. Poornima, this is for the unorganized sector. 1,000 rupees, if they pay 1,000 rupees, and if the state government also contributes, this is the 1,000 rupees what Dr. Mungekar is talking about is from the center. Let us assume that the states also contribute to it. So 1,500 or 2,500 rupees, let us say, is it a decent amount for an elderly person to have some dignity in their life?
See, actually, I'm talking about, I come from a background where I work with waste pickers.
Right.
And I'm really reflecting back on what waste pickers say about this. And when we started talking about pension, what a waste picker really said to me was, ki, it is not that we want 5,000 rupees or 10,000 rupees, but we want it as a right. So really the question is, 1,500, yes. I mean, 1,500 is something to live on. 200 and 300 is like giving alms to a beggar.
Absolutely.
And this is not we are not talking about begging. We are talking about paying back because these people have contributed to the economy during their working
right.
lives. So therefore, 1500 is something that is workable. Yes, it is something that we can look at and move with. But really, it is a matter of right. So it is not something that the government is doling out in its largesse, but it's something that it's recognizing the value of the contribution of these people and right. giving that.
Giving back
yes.
to them.
Oh, yes,
what,
certainly.
What they had given to the
certainly,
country.
Yes.
Vimla ji, aapko kya lagta hai? Ki 1000 ya 1500 rupai agar fix karenge, to isse logon ka zindagi chal jayega? Ya uska thoda dignity aa jayenge uske zindagi mein, unke zindagi mein?
जिंदगी चल जाएगा ये तो बहुत बड़ी बात है लेकिन कुछ उसको मदद मिल जाएगा कि जब वो इस उम्र में काम करते करते वो तो खैर 45 से तो बूढ़े हो जाते हैं लेकिन जब वो 50 55 60 में आते हैं तो बहुत उनको कमजोरी आ जाती है तो थोड़ा सा पैसा हाथ में होने से पैसा ऐसी चीज है कि इंसान को थोड़ा सा
साहस दिलाता है
तो थोड़ा सा पैसा आएगा तो अपना दवाई कर सकता अपनी मर्जी से कुछ अपने पर दवाई ले सकता है या पेट भर खाना या कुछ घर वाले भी थोड़ा सा सोचेंगे भाई हाँ चलो सेवा कर दो कुछ तो पैसा
आ रहा है
तो फर्क तो वो हम ये नहीं कह सकते कि इससे उनकी जिंदगी बहुत बड़ी सुधर जाएगी लेकिन जो आज वो बिल्कुल भीख मांगना और चूल्हा चौका 70 75 65 साल की बूढ़ी जा रही है काम करने और उनको भी काम 200 रुपया पूरा दिन में वो कमाती हैं तो कम से कम उससे कुछ तो उनको मतलब हम तो ये विश्वास से इस आंदोलन को आगे बढ़ाने और इसमें बैठे हैं कि सरकार चाहेगी तो वो कर सकती है ऐसा नहीं है पैसे की बहुत बड़ी बात नहीं है वो अपना ठीक से करेंगे तो पैसा हमें लगता है कि नहीं कमी नहीं है अगर उसको सही सिस्टम से लागू करेंगे तो उन लोगों का जो कहते हैं ना गरीब नहीं है गरीबी हटानी है तो गरीबी हटानी है तो गरीबों के लिए थोड़ा सा आपको सोचना होगा और ये एपीएल बीपीएल कैटेगरी खत्म करनी होगी
ठीक है निखिल नो वी आर जस्ट कम टू द एंड ऑफ इट व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन इन अदर कंट्रीज व्हिच इज द कंट्री यू नो इकॉनमी लाइक इंडिया द साइज ऑफ इंडिया व्हिच कंट्री कैन वी लुक अप टू if we have to bring about something like this in this country?
I think there are two things. One is, yes, there are enough examples in countries around the world. It's accepted. It's accepted certainly in the Western countries. But everyone in India says, oh, we are not a Western country. We are not a developed capitalist country. But we are unwilling to take the other parts of those capitalist countries, which is that you have higher tax to GDP ratios,
right.
double the amount of India. So actually, it's not looking at the 5 lakh crores, which Dr. Mungekar is talking about, but saying, where can we get more
two
money?
Lakh. In? He said 2 lakh crores.
No, 5 lakh of the plan expenditure.
Okay.
Let's start looking at where more money can come in, which should come in. We have a growth rate. We should start getting some of that money for developing our country and our people for the security. Today, we have to understand in countries, as I mentioned, South Africa is
Brazil. I'm told Brazil
has fantastic. Again, people give arguments, oh, it's a much richer country. But Brazil, some years ago, was in a similar standard of living as India. It gives a pension of half a minimum wage where their minimum wage is $1,400 US a month. And everyone gets it automatically. It's universal. They have a whole lot of other social security nets from Anganwadi, from the cradle to the grave. And that is how they are keeping that society.
We are pretty far from that kind of
situation. But one last quick thing.
Yes.
This is a very important political question. There are 10 crore people. They are voters.
Absolutely.
They are going to, through this campaign, we are going to make sure that this is something that every political party will realize, that if they don't pay attention at the next election, these are people who will talk with their votes.
Okay. That's a very positive note to end on, at least for the political parties. This is a message that they are not just some hopelessly neglected elderly people. They are voters. So hopefully the political parties, all the political parties will take note of this and provide and give to them what they had given to the country. Thanks to all my guests, Dr. Bhalchandra Mungekar, Nikhil Day, Poornima Chikermane and Vimala. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue on the big picture.